Now, I know what you're thinking. This installation behind us looks incredibly complicated, but in this video, we're going to show you it's not. So you can take the glasses off, Gary. We're going to step through the installation of this mechanical extract and ventilation from Envirovent with the MEV range.
Not that I don't trust you, I'm going to leave the glasses on for a moment. Can you just explain to me what I've got behind me?
Okay, so this is an alternative to the traditional extractor fans. So think of the rooms where you may have an extractor fan, the bathroom, a utility room, kitchen, anywhere where there's lots of moisture. So instead of the separate fans, we've got one centralized fan, and as a result of that, pipes that would go off to those individual rooms.
Okay.
And obviously you've got air coming in, you need air coming out, and there's our extractor that leaves the building. Apart from that, we've got a power supply, some other features we'll come on to. That's it.
Okay, they're staying on for a second. Let's take the cover off and have a look what's inside here.
So let's start by isolating the supply, and we'll remove our cover. There's four screws, keep the cover on, and just lift the cover off. There's even sound insulation in the cover as well. So what we've found during this video, it's all about how you install it to get it ultra silent. If you do something wrong, you hear a noise, and we'll come up with some of the other reasons for that. So here's the fan itself, so the fan motor, and then we've got six different inlet positions which are blanked off. You see there's one there, two, three, four, five, and six. So there's the pipes that go off to the room. Got our controls there for commissioning and setting the trickle or boost ventilation rates, and this little clever little sensor here. So we've got a humidity sensor here, so this is one way of putting the fan into boost mode. It will detect the humidity coming in from any of the rooms. So say someone's taking a shower, as soon as it detects humidity, it tracks it. So more humidity, faster fan speed. So really, it's not a complex unit. As we said there, it's all about careful installation to keep the noise down. This unit's got vibration mounts. We've got our four mounting positions at the back through the unit, but behind them there's some little rubber pads, again, to isolate it from the building and help reduce vibration.
Now we're at the room end. So it was a real easy process from our MEV 160 to here to install this fast-track semi-rigid ducting. However, for more information about different types of ducting and how best to install them, I recommend you check out our CPD. I'll leave a link in the description below. So let's see how easy it is to install this fast-track ducting system. We are pulling in the 75mm fast-track. They also do a 90mm version as well.
Yeah, this is so easy to install. It's an installer's dream compared to rigid ducting systems, especially with these web joists where you can just bend it around wherever you need to go.
And it doesn't matter if it was an I-joist either, because we know we can drill a hole almost anywhere we like in an I-joist and any size.
Yeah, so let's just recap what you'd be doing with rigid ducting system. You'd be trying to get those fixed pipes in between the joists. Yeah, not easy, they don't bend. And then fixing the corners on, you know, glued and screwed, but then someone else comes along and actually disrupts them and disconnects them, you know, when another trade's in. Not easy to install.
The fast track system is twice as fast as the traditional screwed and glued version.
So let's see how easy it is to connect a valve adapter to our fast track system.
Okay, that valve adapter being the one above our heads.
Yeah, so put the O-ring seal around the end of the fast track ducting, and then we're going to bring in a clip ring, which again fastens around the tube itself.
This means we don't need any glue and we don't need any screws.
No, this is super quick and, you know, produces a very reliable seal. So just bring it up to our valve adapter, noting where the little clip is there, and there's a little barb on the clip ring itself, and then just push it into place, give it a click, and that is the connection made.
And if you pan back now, you can see how easy it was to get those fast track ducting in, adjusting them now, swooping through the web joists. That's a simple system. I think we demonstrated there how easy the fast track system is to install. However, on your outlet, you have used a rigid pipe.
Yeah, I just thought I'd like to compare and contrast what you'd have to do if we were fitting a rigid pipe in this system. So I've brought it in, and then there's a small length of flexible ducting to damp any vibrations. But again, there's quite a process involved in wrestling that onto the pipe and the junction. But again, the fast track comes straight into the unit. So let's have a look at how we did that, Gary.
I'm going to take out a blanking cap. In order to do so, just give it a small turn. You'll hear it click and it frees itself and allows me then to put in a spigot.
Yeah, so the spigot needs separating in two. There's a screw in the middle. So just bringing in the speedy here to separate the two halves.
And that first half is going to go back in the hole we've just obviously opened out with exactly the same process, just that small turn and get it to click and lock into position.
Yeah, and there's just two arrows we're looking for that when they're aligned it is in the right place. So just give it a turn and there we are.
Okay, and then you're going to re-screw the rest of the spigot together, and these are designed for the 75mm fast track.
Yes, that's it. Yeah, so just screw them back together, and then it's very easy. Same process as we had on the outlet. We're looking to align that click ring, and it just clicks into place.
Super simple. Going to go on and now look at doing the same process for the 90mm.
Yes, and then there's just an intermediate adapter that goes in between the spigot and the fast track ducting for the larger diameter. But it's the same click-in process. Yeah, nice airtight seal, really easy.
Hopefully we've managed to demonstrate there how easy this system is to install, but let's now talk about modes of operation.
Okay, now at the minute we're in trickle mode. We can almost hear the fan. It is whisper quiet, but let's think about humidity first. So the little sensor in there we showed at the start of the video, that's measuring the amount of moisture in the air that's flowing through the unit. And if it detects an increase, it will increase the fan speed. So say someone's in the shower or someone's enthusiastically boiling something in the kitchen, that'll kick in and the fan speed will increase to increase the ventilation.
Okay, so that's all right, but I'm now seeing a boost button here. If it automatically can sense humidity and obviously raise the speed of the motor, therefore the extraction in the system, why would I need a boost button?
Well, there's times when it's not moisture that needs to increase the ventilation. Yeah, sometimes we have situations down here at Lineside Studios where we have a challenging situation in the toilet and we need to increase the amount of ventilation in the area. Similar thing happens at home. I've been banned from cooking kippers due to the pungent aroma, so this boost function could get me out of that.
Can you run me through some of these boost options? It almost looks like we've got a light switch here, Gordon.
Yeah, it's because it is a light switch, Gary, but it's not wired in the lighting circuit. There's a volt-free contact, two wires that come out of the unit to trigger the boost function, so connect them together and the fan speed will increase. I'll go into boost mode. I'll just do that. Let's have a... There it goes.
Yeah, doesn't take long, does it?
No, and you can tell there's a lot of air now rushing through this unit. I think we've turned it up max when we did the commissioning, so we've probably overdone it a little bit. So just switch that off. The other option is to use a switch live input, very much the same you would do with a normal extractor fan. So connect that to your bathroom lighting circuit, and that will then trigger it to go into boost mode.
And that's a traditional system we're used to doing, that we turn on the bathroom light and the fan comes on, etc.
Yeah, we can also get a 0 to 10 volt input version of this fan, and we've shown how that 0 to 10 volt technology works in the previous video we made about this silent eco or inline fan. That can also be coupled with some wireless sensors to trigger, so you don't necessarily then need to worry about wiring to different places. Then you can use multiple sensors.
What can we sense with those sensors then?
Okay, so the obvious one is humidity that we've done here, but you can also get a VOC sensor. So
I can't remember.
Volatile organic compounds. So that's the sort of gas that comes off from new furniture and some synthetic carpets and things like that. It can be quite damaging to the health in some environments, so a lot of people pay attention to that. And increasingly now, CO2 sensors are used as well. And again, we showed that in that previous video, so check out that if you haven't seen those wireless sensors and how they're set up.
Nothing's been difficult so far, but under here, I found the controls. Can you talk me through the commissioning process?
Yeah, dead easy. Just push and hold this set button to enter the commissioning mode. So 4 seconds, and there you can see flashing light. So we're now gonna set the maximum flow rate for the boost function, so you can, plus or minus to raise or lower, and then to set the same for the trickle mode, push the button again, you'll see flashing mode under trickle, and then again we can adjust the speed for the trickle. You would need an airflow meter to do this to match what's required in the building regulations.
Is there anything I've got to do, say, at the vents when in each of the areas?
So then you will, it's an iterative process, but you may need to fine-tune the flow rate in each room by adjusting the room valves.
Well, I think I've been wearing these unnecessarily during this video.
Yeah, you're right, Gary. This is an incredibly easy system, easy to install, lots of great features. But you go to a site, you see these sitting in the cupboard. If you haven't seen one before or looked inside, it's sort of a bit intimidating, but no, not with this product.
We've got the MEV300 here, which is exactly the same specification for size. It's 160mm deep and it's about 5 kilograms in weight. So just that little bit more performance with the 300.
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned the CPD earlier in the video, but I've watched that and realized I've been doing things wrong for years, actually.
Do you want to elaborate on how wrong you've been for years?
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, if I was doing it now, I would fit one of these. I wouldn't bother with separate fans. I wouldn't bother with rigid ducting. This is a great system, and it's that silent operation, yet doing all the things it has to do.
It's a shame you have to stop talking there, because it sounded like you were wrong for some of that conversation. But as always at eFIXX, we're interested in your feedback. Are you fitting this system from Envirovent, the MEV 160 or 300 system? Is there anything else in the Envirovent range you want to highlight to us? Because everything we've touched on in their range so far has been fantastic. There might be a hidden gem and you want to tell us about it. Leave all those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.